Good morning, everybody. Welcome to church. Probably not the hottest spot on the whole planet, but it might be one of the close ones. But we're just so thankful to be here. Thankful to have Tim Menzies here with us today. And because our air conditioning's not working, we're going to abbreviate the service a little bit, just a little bit, because it's only going to get warmer in here. But we're going to praise the Lord, and we're going to have a good time, and God's just so good. God is so good. So thankful to be here today. So, of course, we have Tim with us today. Another announcement is beginning August 1st, we're going to be doing our annual food drive for the Henry County Help Center for the entire month of August. So when you come in, and if you only are here on Sundays, that's fine. Bring in non-perishable food products for Henry County Help Center. Things like spaghetti, dried beans, rice, things that you can cook and feed a family. Canned vegetables, canned fruit, things that last for a while. But if you think back maybe when you and your family were first getting going and you were eating a lot of spaghetti and a lot of beans and rice, well, think that, because families in need to be able to feed a family. So think about that. Those are the kind of things that they're running low on. I know right now they're especially running low on rice and canned vegetables. So as you're out shopping for yourself, pick up some stuff and bring it in. We'll have a bin back there. Also, it's that time of the year that we do hygiene bags for the Family Resource Center and Miss Renata. So there's a list on the bulletin board back there that you can just take, and it has all the items that go in the hygiene bags. You can do whole bags, or you can just get a few shampoos or conditioners or the things that are on those hygiene bags. And what Miss Renata does at the Family Resource Center, she's heavily connected with the schools. She gets those to kids who have that need. She gives those, she knows the kids that need those bags to get started for another school year, to have those essentials, those necessities that maybe we take for granted that are hard for people in need to obtain those things. So we help out with that every year. It's always a huge, huge help for the kids that get those and the families that get those. So keep that in mind. The hygiene bags, the food drive for the next month for the Henry County Help Center. Any other announcements before we get started? All right. So we're going to start off right away. We're going to sing in your hymnal number 250. We're going to sing our communion song, and we'll go right into our communion time after that. So let's stand and sing this great hymn of our faith together.
Trust in Jesus is to take Him at His word, is to rest upon His promise, is to know that the Lord is Jesus. How I trust Him, how I've proved Him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus.
Heavenly Father, we're so grateful to be gathered here today to praise you, to worship you, and to give thanks for all that you've blessed us with. We gather here in remembrance of the sacrifice that Christ has made on our behalf, that our sins can be forgiven if we believe in him. Please be with us as we worship you today, and keep all those in your prayers that are sick and suffering, and we pray that they will trust in you, Lord. In your name we pray. Amen.
Father God, we're thankful for this Lord's Day, the privilege we have to be in your house, Lord. You know it's a little warm here today, but let us come to this table with a joyful heart of the blessings that you give us each and every day, and we are grateful for that, Lord. As we return a portion to you, will you bless the giver, bless the gift, and use it to further your kingdom. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Thank you, Barbara.
Yes.
So you guys are in for a treat. We have Mr. Tim Menzies with us here today. He's going to come and minister for us in word and song, and you're going to be touched. And He can play a little guitar, too, you'll see here in a little bit. He can pick a little bit, too. So just very excited about having him here today. I do want you to know that after the service, Tim has some CDs and stuff back there. I encourage you to stop by and see that because he is fully funded by his music ministry. Also, at the end of the service, we'll have take up a love offering for him to help cover his cost. He pays for his hotel rooms, travel, car, gas, oil, all that kind of stuff. So we want to bless him, and we want to show him some love today before he leaves. So we'll take care of that at the end. And so I just wanted to make you aware of that and how you feel led to help him out on his way as he leaves us today. And just so thankful to have Tim here. I saw him first at Cowboy Church in LaGrange. Oh gosh, it was right after COVID. I think it was one of your first gigs after COVID, and I'm like, I'm getting this guy. So we're thankful to have him here. So everybody welcome Tim Menzies.
Good morning.
Morning.
I want to start off by thanking Brother Bob for the fans. He said it was my fan club. It's a blessing to be here. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel His mighty power and His grace. I can hear the brush of angels' wings. I see, Lord, on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. And all God's people said, Amen. It's my understanding from the scripture that Jesus could return at any moment. And so Pastor Jeff had a request, and I'm going to do that first in case Jesus comes back before we get out of here, of which I hope He does in the middle of this song. We read in John 1, in the beginning was the Word. We know from verses 14 and 17 of John 1 that Jesus Christ is the Word. So in the beginning was the Word lets us know that in the beginning the Word already was. There's never been a time when Jesus was not. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through Him all things were made. How many things?
All.
I took New Testament Greek until I got kicked out about 3 weeks in for mangling it. They claimed that I had an accent and that I was confusing the other students. So I became the coffee guy. But we started with John 1. And I learned that all, translated from the Greek, means all. We read at the end of Matthew 28, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Surely I am with you. How long?
Always.
Always, yes. I didn't grow up in the church. I didn't grow up hearing those verses or hearing God's Word at all. And when I came to the Lord and read about Him being, Jesus being God and fully man and all that, And when I look back over my life, I saw that Jesus had been there the whole time, even when I was rejecting him. And it led to the writing of this song, and I pray that it blesses you this morning, and I send this to Brother Jeff. And when Neil and the boys came to the moon in that tin can, Gettysburg, Omaha Beach, and Vietnam, I heard every soldier's cry and every mama's prayer. I was there. I was there when you took your first breath, when you lit that stolen lucky strike and like to choke to death, when you were waist deep in Carter's Creek and Pastor John dunked you down in the water and raised you up in air. I was there. Always around. I was then and I am now, and I'll be here when tomorrow comes. When a road comes to an end, I'm where you start again. I'm never far than a word away. You've always got a friend. When your grandma passed, I was in that house. When your grandpa ran down the streets of gold to show her around, I was there. You by a hair. I was there. When you're feeling alone, look up. I'm the one who answers prayers, and I'm always there. God decided to bring his great Old Testament prophet Elijah home. There was no funeral. Chariots of fire and horses of fire came down and carried Elijah up to heaven in a whirlwind. I wouldn't mind one here today. just take us on up. We already got the door open and everything. You can't look out that door and deny creation and a creator. It's just amazing to me how people can do that. Swing low, sweet chariot, come and fold, carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, come and fold, carry me home. Music in Virginia, in bars, and I do not recommend it. It's not the best way to start, I don't think. But we know that we have a transforming Savior, and we all know that verse in Romans 8:28. For God works all things for good for those who love Him and are called according to His purpose. And I'm here today in Kentucky from the Tony's kitchen and the hideaway and the Jersey living, and the Lord used all of that to prepare me for this day, just like He's prepared each one of you for this day. And we're never anywhere by accident, and I'm thankful that we're here together. And the Lord had me fall in love with a Christian woman, and I just thought she was pretty, and the Lord had an eternal plan that I didn't know about. And she was raised in the church Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday night. If their church didn't have something, they'd go across the street to the other one. And when our son was born, she felt compelled to have him in the church. And so she started taking him to a church in the country in Mount Juliet, Tennessee. And it was about this size. And they were going to church every Sunday. And I refused to go. It isn't that I didn't go, Miss Barbara. I refused. I didn't need it. And one Sunday when he was about five, they came home from church and I was sitting in the kitchen half asleep. And he walked up to me and stopped. And my boy was hyperactive when he was little. No sugar, no caffeine. He was Lord sent him that way. But this day he stopped and he stood still. And he said, "How come Mammy and Papa go to church and me and Mama go to church and you don't?" 5-year-old trapping me in my own kitchen. I didn't know the Lord and I didn't know what was happening. John Wesley talked about grace. There's only one grace, but he would teach it in three stages sometimes to help us comprehend it. There's the prevenient grace, and that's when grace is acting and you don't know it. And the Lord is wooing you. We know from 1 John 4:19, we love because he what? First loved us. And so that grace that goes before. And then we have the justifying grace of when we receive Jesus Christ. And then the sanctifying grace is from the point we're saved to the rest of our life down here of trying to become more Christ-like. As John the Baptist said, more of him and less of me. But I didn't know any of that, and I didn't know that prevenient grace was taking over that kitchen. And after I had stared at my boy a little while, and my first thought was not holy, I thought with him being hyperactive, something else will cross his mind, and he'll take off, and I don't have to deal with it. But the Lord had his feet nailed to that floor, and he just stared me down. And eventually I said, "Well, I'm going to start going." And the Lord knew that I didn't lie to my son even when I was lost. And so the next Sunday, we went to church. And when I went in that building, I felt what I later came to understand was the presence of the Holy Spirit and the body of Christ. Us, these are the temples of the Holy Spirit now. I didn't know any of that, but I knew that I needed whatever they had. And I've barely missed a Sunday since. My wife used to pray, "Lord, bring him to the church." And now I go to several hundred, but not hers. Now she's saying, "Bring him home to church once in a while." We recently had our 41st anniversary. And for the first 39 years, she called them an annual review. The first few years we were married and I hadn't opened the Bible, she told me it's in the Bible. About the reviewing part, and I don't know about that. Yeah, I know. A friend of mine said that might have been the Queen James translation. So if the review went well, then she'd tell me we had an annual renewal, you know. But I felt like I was on trial there every year. So coming up on 40, I lobbied to be grandfathered in, I'm thankful she agreed, so we've decided to stick it out. Yep, ma'am?
Congratulations.
Thank you. That's right. And I don't have to start behaving 30 days before the anniversary now, or the review. The funny thing, too, Brother Jeff, the review was always one way. We weren't both reviewing.
Right. Yeah.
Now, ain't that, that's kind of interesting, isn't it? Yeah. It was always whether I'm passing the review. And I was on probation a few times. But she grew up in the church. And when I started going, then she wanted to join a Bible study. And in that same kitchen, I heard me say, "I want to go too." And you ever say something and you just want to grab it back? Because I didn't know what a Bible study was. And so we started at Genesis 1 and went through Revelation 22, 34 weeks, very intense. And during that time in the fall of 1991 while studying the Old Testament. The Lord started transforming my heart, and I received Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior in 1991. And then I realized as I studied how the eternal fisherman works, that he had used my son to bring me to his son. And I'm still amazed by that. And now I get to spend eternity with God's son and mine. That's a pretty good exchange for hell. So my wife's great-great-grandfather helped build a church like this. And we would go clean and take care of the grave sites. It's the cemetery around the church. And he's buried right there. He's one of the first ones. And even when I was lost, I thought it was very interesting that he's buried feet away from the church that he helped nail together. Well, then as I learned about the church being the body of Christ and that we're going to be caught up as the church and realize that he's going to come out of that ground right there beside the church that he physically helped build with his hands, but now he's going to come up in the resurrection. I'm just still fascinated by that and led to the writing of this song. And this is my wife's story. Brother Guthrie owned 4 acres just outside that Tulane town. One night he had a vision, saw God's plan for that piece of ground. Every board, every pew, the stained glass too. Before you could say amen, the cornerstone was set. From the first nail to the steeple, without a single sin debt. The whole town answered the call. Church went up in no time, in the twinkling of an eye. Built on the rock of ages, built to stand the test of time. I grew up on the stories about the sweat, the blood, the glory. I thank God I was raised in the church. Brother Guthrie ain't missed a sermon now since 1889. He's never late on Sunday, first headstone on the right. Rest in peace, thank you, sir. 'Cause in this church, I gave my heart to Jesus, learned the word and how to pray. Said wedding vows and heard my children sing Amazing Grace. Old timers love to talk about how the church went up in no time, in the twinkling of an eye. Built on the rock of ages, built to stand the test of time. I grew up on the stories about the sweat, the blood, the glory. I thank God was raised in the church. Last night I had a vision. Jesus came down in the cloud. When that trumpet blew, Brother Guthrie knew the Lord was breaking ground. The church went up in no time, in the twinkling of an eye. Built on the rock of ages, built to stand the test of time. I grew up on the stories about the sweat, the blood, the glory. I thank God I'll be raised with all the other sinners Jesus saved in the church. In the church. I moved to Nashville to be in country music, and I made a living writing country songs for 30 years. And it was just as rough as you've heard that it is. And slept in the back of my truck for months, taking showers at truck stops and whatnot. But I was young enough to think, well, I'm here, so I'm okay. And that's back when I, y'all remember, some of you are young enough to still do this, but where eating and sleeping is a choice when you're in your 20s. Y'all enjoy that. It's going away. So, but I was young enough to choose when I ate and slept, thank God. And I'd call home and talk to family members and friends, and I didn't lie to them, but I didn't tell them everything. And I think they thought that since I was still in Nashville, I must be doing okay. But my mother, from 650 miles away, she always still had her mama radar on full tilt. And back in, that's at payphones. And so I'm in a, y'all remember when Nissans were called Datsuns? Yeah. I had a Datsun pickup. And I'd call on a payphone from that Datsun pickup, which coincidentally did not have AC. So I'm kind of coming home here. I tell you what, when I got here setting up, that's where I got hot, you know. And Bob hadn't blessed me with this fan yet. And I started thinking, you know, if there was water in that baptismal, I might change my theology on rebaptizing. Y'all come in, I'm back here professing my faith one more time. The first time that I read Luke 1 with the mother of our Lord was with child by the Holy Spirit, and she visited her relative Elizabeth, who we also know was with child to be John the Baptist. And when Elizabeth heard Mary's voice, the baby in Elizabeth's womb leaped for joy. Elizabeth did not need to see John's face or have words with him. She knew the heart of her child. And we know that's a miracle. But some of us who are parents and grandparents also know that loving mothers know the heart of their children because it's a godly relationship. It's not just sales. And so I wrote this song, and a group called Shenandoah had it out. And I was able to add some bologna to my mayonnaise sandwiches. Crowder and a single cigarette, crouched down in a stall out in the barn. 3 puffs later, we were sick as we could get, praying we'd get better before we got home. She saw me coming through the back door screen, and I knew the minute that she looked at me, Mama knows, Mama knows. Sometimes I think she's got a window to my soul. Mama knows, Mama knows. Even when I think it doesn't show, Mama knows. Johnson ankle deep in ocean waves, pants rolled up and hearts out on our sleeves, both feeling more than either one of us could say. That first love left the sweetest memory. 15 and shy, I didn't tell my soul. Now how is it Mama never has to be told? Mama knows, Mama knows. Sometimes I think she's got a window to my soul. Mama knows, Mama knows. Even when I think it doesn't show, Mama knows. I wasn't home when Mama passed away. Didn't get to say I love you, but I've got this feeling, Mama knows, Mama knows. Sometimes I think she's got a window to my soul. Mama knows, Mama knows. Even when I think it doesn't show, Mama knows, Mama knows, Mama knows. If y'all notice in the bridge of that song, we sent Mama to be with Jesus. And I'm thankful to announce that my mother just had her 87th birthday. And so the first time she heard that song, she didn't like it as much as everybody else. I grew up in a little town called Mechanicsville, Virginia. And about the time that I had convinced her that when you write songs, you know, you got to make it to where somebody else can sing it. It can't just be all personal. And about the time I think she was accepting it, the Mechanicsville local called the house and wanted to know when she passed away. That didn't help me. And so even to this day, and that's been 25 or 30 years, once or twice a year, usually around Mother's Day, you know, I'll say Happy Mother's Day, and she'll say, you remember that song where you killed me in the bridge? Yes, Mom, I do. Hey, we just went to Israel in May, and we were supposed to go in 2020, and of course everything kept getting canceled, and she's 87. And so with each year that canceled, she wanted to go, and we kept getting canceled. And so we just got back. We went in May, and my 87-year-old mother, she was 86 then, went to Israel with us and walked every step that we took. And on those tours, you walk 3 to 5 miles a day. Because Jesus' whole ministry was in about a 30-mile radius. And so you do a lot of walking. And I just think it was supernatural that she walked all of that. And you had a lot of middle-aged men. If it was getting a little bit warm and you're looking at an incline that you got to climb, and they start thinking about, well, I might skip this one, you know. And there goes my mom, 86 years old. And they were like, well, I better go. You know? Yeah. So she held the whole tour, feet to the fire. We read in Romans 3:22, that we've all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, guilty. And I wrote this song with a friend of mine, Daryl Worley, that y'all might know. And he was going to do a Christian album, and something happened business-wise, and he didn't do it. And we wrote this song. So then, when he didn't do it, I did. And so now it's mine. Down here. We got dust on the Bible, need some Holy Ghost revival. Gotta get a lawyer if you pray in school. Crooked politicians dividing me and you, when what we really need's a little golden rule. Do unto others as you have them do. Who knows, they might just do it back to you. It's in the book, you made it perfectly clear. Lord, I know you know we made a mess down here. Been completely overwhelmed with the biblical truth that Jesus was fully God and fully man while he walked on the earth. Just always fascinated by that. Brother Jeff and Bob and I were talking this morning about the living word in Hebrews, and that we can read the same verse over and over again for decades, and each time it might speak to us in a way where we thought, well, I've never seen that before. Somebody added a word in my Bible while I was asleep. John 1 verse 14, the word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only, who came from the Father full of grace. Verse 17 of John 1, for the law was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, but God the one and only, who is at the Father's side, has made him known. We rightfully acknowledge that Mother Teresa decided or was led to spend her ministry in the slums of Calcutta, and that was quite a sacrifice. But we read in Philippians 2 that Jesus did not see equality with God as something to be grasped, but humbled himself even to death on a cross and came in a human body. So that contrast between the throne and one of these, this is about the biggest demotion a human's ever taken. And he did it for us. He didn't need the cross. The only human that's ever walked the planet that didn't need the cross was Jesus. And every one of us do need it. And that's why he came. This song is about him being fully God and fully man when he was in his earthly ministry. departed from the feast. I sat there surrounded by all the Pharisees. They said, "Who did you study under, son? How old are you? Are you here alone? Tell us, where are you from?" Well, on my mother's side, I just turned 12 years old. Born just down the road, down in Bethlehem. But on my father's side, I'm older than time. I am the light from up on high, the perfect Lamb, the great I am. On my father's side, when I knelt by that olive tree to pray, a part of me was tempted to turn and run away. But I came in the flesh to pay the price, to hang on the cross, redeem the lost. And I knew it was time. But on my mother's side, I was sweating blood, praying, "Take this cup if there's another way." But on my father's side, I knew the plan we made was the only way the world could be saved, and through me you could be. On my father's side, where the angels pray, watching me hang there, then I heard all hell shake, break out in praise. On my mother's side, I felt each Roman nail. I could feel my body fail with every passing breath. But on my father's side, I rose from the grave. I've prepared a place we can hardly wait for you to see. Your home with me. On my father's side. On my father's side. I need a little help on this next song, and I don't want you to stand up and do jumping jacks or nothing, because you might get hot. But y'all can sing just a little bit and let the fans carry the voices around. I'll sing a line in the verse. It's an old Bill Monroe bluegrass song. Old John, what did he say? And y'all sing, "Walking in Jerusalem just like John. I'll meet you there on the crowning day, walking in Jerusalem just like John." There you go. And the chorus is, "I want to be ready. I want to be ready. I want to be ready. I want to be ready, Lord, to walk in Jerusalem just like John." And at the end, we say, "Walk in Jerusalem just like John," three times for the Trinity. Now, Jesus says in Matthew 24, "Be watchful and ready." Are y'all ready? All right. Oh, John, what did he say?
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I'll meet you there on the crowning day. I wanna be ready, Lord, to walk in Jerusalem just like John. Amen. We all come broken and some come lame.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
By grace we come shouting in Jesus' name. I wanna be ready. I wanna be ready. I wanna be ready, Lord. Walking in Jerusalem just like John. I wanna be ready. I wanna be ready. I wanna be ready, Lord. Walking in Jerusalem just like John. We'll rise and shine in glory.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
Until then, we'll sing this gospel story.
Walking in Jerusalem just like John.
I want to be ready. I want to be ready. I want to be ready, Lord. Walking in Jerusalem just like John. I want to be ready. Walking in Jerusalem just like John. Walking in Jerusalem just like John. Amen. Congratulations. Y'all sung yourself into a non-paying job. Please join me on this one. And if you do good, we'll double the pay. On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. I'll cherish the old rugged cross, beautiful, till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday. We read in 1 Corinthians 2 that the spiritual man learns things not from man's wisdom, but through the Spirit. And my mother-in-law, that I told you earlier, raised my wife in the church. She grew up singing in the church. And towards the end of her life, she had a debilitating case of Alzheimer's. And about 30% of Alzheimer's patients don't sleep a lot. And she was one of those. And so she would walk. If she was awake, she was walking. It was amazing. And then she would sleep for about 90 minutes, and then she was up walking again. Well, and then, of course, she started taking off and going places and wouldn't stay in the car and that kind of thing. And so eventually she ended up, we had to go to a memory unit. And we took a little guitar and left it in her room. And those of y'all who have experience with memory units, you know that what you leave in a room never stays in that room. It just, you just don't know where it went. But it'll come back around sometimes. And so at this point, she didn't know us. She was unable to read her own name on her door. And she was what they classified then as nonverbal. And that guitar would show back up, and she'd hit a note, and she would sing, "So I'll cherish the old rugged cross." And she stopped there. But she wasn't talking, and she would sing that title. And I became convinced over those months, and it makes sense if you think about it, the Holy Spirit indwelling in us does not get Alzheimer's. It's just the brain. And I believe that she was still communing with Jesus Christ right till the end. And she had learned, "I'll cherish the old rugged cross," through her spirit, not through her brain. 1 Corinthians 2. Look at that when you get home. And I was reminded of Philippians when Paul was jailed. And he was writing the book of Philippians, and he said, "The gospel cannot be chained." But we also learned that it can't be kept in a memory unit, because those nurses heard her. And they knew that she wasn't talking. And they hear her saying about the cross. And so we see what a witness that was. That's one of my fans. That last one, that last message got that one fan. Yeah. So I've never had a fan crash to the floor like that. So we know that those nurses were witnessed to by a nonverbal Christian. And I just think that's fascinating. It's been such a blessing to be with y'all today. And y'all are troopers. We kind of went old church on them today, didn't we, Brother Jeff? Amen. This is a little house on the prairie kind of church right here. I want to thank Brother Jeff for inviting me and Miss Rose. I know any of us know that when someone is in ministry, the whole family is in ministry. And it's good to see my friends from also, I believe it was a cowboy church where we met, wasn't it? And then I know y'all came to join them too. And all. And Brother Bob helped me unload the van. Now, my first impression of Brother Bob wasn't the best. Yeah. So we both pulled up at the same time, and I thought, well, that's nice timing. Thank you, Lord. And he got out, you know, he's tall, brother, and I'm thinking, okay, everybody can't be short, you know. And he comes back, and the first thing he said was, "Full disclosure, the air is out in the church." And we're sitting out there, and then I said, and I'm looking at those stairs, 1, 2, 3, and all this equipment's mine. And I said, "Is this how we're going into church?" And he said, "Yep." And there was a negative number 2 on Brother Bob. But then Brother Bob started grabbing stuff out of the van, and bringing it in and helping me and getting these fans going and getting the ceiling fans, and went home and got this fan that's kept me from passing out for the past 45 minutes. And so, Brother Bob, I love you. Amen. And he's going on a golf trip, and I never, you know, I don't know golf, but I hope you win every round or whatever it is y'all call them. I hope it's the best golf trip you've ever had. You bless me today, and I thank you. We know the world is a mess, and we also know that the world is behaving just like it's supposed to. And the church is becoming more and more of a remnant. And that's exactly what this book said was going to happen. And so we're looking up. And if he has us here, you know, the Lord could save us the moment we're saved. He could bring us home. But we're supposed to be salt and light right till the end. And that's what we're doing here now. We read in Matthew 24. The words of Jesus, he said, no one knows about that day or hour. He's talking about his return. Not even the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. This was when he was in his human form. As it was in the days of Noah, so it will be at the coming of the Son of Man. For in the days before the flood, people were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, up to the day Noah entered the ark. And they knew nothing about what would happen until the flood came and took them all away. We read in the Old Testament, who shut the door on the ark? God. Once he shuts the door, it's shut. And the church door, the age of grace, there's an end to that time period that we're in. This dispensation will end. It says it in its book over and over. He's saying it right here in Matthew 24. And we don't know when. But when that door closes, it's closed. That is how it will be with the coming of the Son of Man. Therefore, keep watch, because you do not know on what day the Lord will come. But understand this. The Son, you must be ready, because the Son of Man will come at an hour when you do not expect him. And I know that most of us that would be here this morning are expecting it, and we're ready. But if there's any doubt in your mind that you want to settle up, that Jesus is your Savior, that you've trusted him as your Lord, there's no better time to take care of that than today. We're already hot. Just stay a few more minutes and get cool. You don't want to get that hot. Yeah. And so this year is good evangelism, you know, really. We don't want this kind of a preview of where the other side's going to be like. And so if you do know him as your Lord and Savior, there's no better time to thank him than this morning. It's been a blessing to be with y'all. And this next song is kind of a speaking about the times we're in. And I love y'all, and I'm thank you for inviting me. There's power in those pages. Grab a Bible, look it up. You won't find a loophole to water down the blood. That crown of thorns was jagged, the nails pierced in the wood. We can't sugarcoat the story just to make the lost feel good. Now if that rubs you wrong, take it up with the boss, cause I ain't sanding off the edges of that old rugged cross. I ain't apologizing for standing on the truth. I won't stand before the Lord with some old lame excuse. I'm marching right behind him. He said, don't count the cost, so I ain't sanding off the edges of that old rugged cross. I'll tell it on the mountain and everywhere I go. don't worry if he steps on your toes. That old serpent likes to whisper lies into our ear. Like, don't believe the scripture, we don't need this part right here. Well, he's pulled that Santa garden. Hey, get behind me, hoss, 'cause I ain't sanding off the edges of that old rugged cross. I ain't apologizing for standing on the truth. I won't stand before the Lord with some old lame excuse. I'm marching right behind him. He said, don't count the cost. So I ain't sending off the edges of that old rugged cross. South. Don't get left behind, my friend. You're either in or out. I ain't apologizing for standing on the truth. I won't stand before the Lord with some old lame excuse. I'm marching right behind him. He said, don't count the cost. So I ain't sanding off the edges of that old rugged cross. Tell the truth and trust the message. Don't stand off the edges of that old rugged cross.
Is it going to be good? Thank you all so much for hanging in here. Thank you so much, Tim. Thank you, Bob, for keeping him from having some type of awful heat stroke thing up here with a fan, because that was probably the difference. Thank you all for coming out. I would like to pass around for a love offering. And we'll get some more information if you want and feel led to do that, but don't have the means by which to do that today. Then we'll get a mailing address or something so that we can bless him and take care of him, because this is expensive work. You have to buy all that equipment and all that sort of stuff and travel. He pays all his own travel expenses. So Maddie, would you take that around to everybody and let's take care of Tim and bless him the way that we know that we can, and because he's been a tremendous blessing here today. His message, it's the scripture. It's the holy word of God. And so it's the truth, and the world needs that more than anything. The world needs an old rugged cross that is rough and hard, and we don't need to take the rough edges off, because the truth is what sets people free. Not easy. Easy doesn't set people free. The truth sets people free. So so thankful for everybody here. Tim's going to be at the back if you are interested in a CD or more information about him. He can tell you where you can find more about his ministry, about his music. If you did any looking around, there's tons of videos out there of him on different shows and things. He's all over the place. Oh, he's all over the place. So thank you. So I'm going to close this in prayer, and I want to give you one more opportunity. If you came to this place today, not sure if Jesus is your Lord and Savior, come talk to me. I'll stay up here and make sure you come speak to me, and I will be glad to talk with you, pray with you, because this is a party you want to attend. This is where you want to be. You want to be where Jesus is. So, again, so thankful, so thankful. So we'll let you get out of here in a minute and get in your cars and turn the air conditioning on. Hopefully everybody has air conditioning in their cars today. So, all right, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, we just praise you and thank you for your word. Lord Jesus, that you were there. You're there every time anything happens to us. You're always here. You're always here with us, Lord Jesus. Father God, Lord Jesus, as we look, that we're so thankful to be on the Father's side. Lord Jesus, that you've adopted each and every one of us who has called you by name. You've adopted us into your family, Lord. We're so thankful for that, Lord. Lord Jesus, we just praise you and thank you for everything. Lead us, guide us. Lord, we pray over Brother Tim's ministry, Father God, that you'll continue to bless him and his family, Lord. His music, that is your music. Father God, do with it what you need to do, Lord Jesus, that people will be touched, lives will be changed. Lord Jesus, people will, just like Tim did in his kitchen that day, Lord Jesus, have an awareness. I got to change something. I need Jesus in my life. So, Lord Jesus, we pray over everyone who is lost and unsaved, Lord Jesus. Father God, we just pray over their souls. Lord, thank you so much. Bless this day. Keep us all safe as we travel. Be with everybody on our prayer list, Lord Jesus. Everybody we know and love. In your holy and precious, mighty and amazing name we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you all. Love you all. And I'll see you all real soon.